When I found out I was going to become a father, because I didn't have a father around, I had to consciously understand what type of parent I was going to be. When my daughter came, I didn't really know what to do. She didn't really connect with me. So I found that very, very difficult. And my wife was amazing. So she took on a lot more of the workload while I was figuring that out. To be honest, I never really burdened her with what I was thinking and feeling at that time. I think the sort of predefined idea is that men just support their wives and not really make too much noise and get in the way. And so I didn't really know what my role was. That part was really difficult. So ideas around masculinity, what roles you play at work, what roles you play at home in the family. Work was quite stressful. And so there was a massive build up while I was away for the 2 weeks.
And I think I was powering through just on the belief that I could, because I think that's what you should say to yourself.
It's a very unique problem to have in terms of balancing yourself, your family, your marriage, your work. And you're trying to be present, but you're also trying to protect yourself from burnout from when you're working. You never really get it right.
I don't ever want to have to collapse. There's no point me burning out at work and then coming home and my children get the last of what's available. I want them to have really good memories of us growing up, and I think I preserve some of that for that reason, but also just sometimes just very much for myself. I needed a group of people to share stuff with because I had loads of questions and I had loads of difficult days which I wanted to tell people about.
And so I put all my friends in a WhatsApp group
called Dope Black Dads.
Ever since, it's grown into a digital safe space. It's a place where fathers can come together. The podcast has around about 5,000 to 7,000 listeners each week. Mainly what it's talking about is things to do with parenting, cohabiting, marriage, ourselves, how to be better people, and then hopefully that makes us better parents.
I built it quite purely because it was for myself, it was a selfish resource. And then hearing people say that it means something to them and that they've learned things about themselves is the best feeling in the world, because it means it's really working. I think strength is an internal thing. I think it's your ability to handle pressure, but also to be vulnerable, because it's actually harder to be vulnerable than it is to be traditionally strong. And so I'm always in trying to encourage people just to be as in touch with themselves as humanly possible. Sharing makes us stronger.